Hello students. Students, today we are just continuing your previous chapter, so let's get started. Class 3, today we are just winding up your chapter number 9, that is your time. Okay, first we will do a quick revision of what we have done in our previous video. In our previous video, we have done conversion of time. Okay, so I'm doing one question that convert days into hours. So you have to convert these 20 days into hours. Now, in one day, how many hours you are having? 24 hours. Therefore, in 20 days, you will be having 20 into 24 hours. Okay, this is the way I told you to do your work. Now, when you multiply these two, you are getting 480 hours. It means in 20 days, how many hours you are having? 480. So when you have to convert days into hours, what you have to do? You have to multiply the number of days by 24. Okay. Next, we are having convert hours into minutes. Now you have to convert these hours into minutes. So first is your 15 hour. So converting 15 hour into minutes, you will write 1 hour is equals to how many minutes? 60 minutes. Okay, in 1 hour we are having 60 minutes. Therefore, in 15 hours, how many minutes? 15 into 60 minutes. Clear? Now, when you multiply these two, you are getting 900 minutes. It means in 15 hour you are having 900 minutes. So when you have to convert hours into minute, what you have to do? You have to multiply the given number of hours with 60. Clear? Next, we are having convert minutes into second. Now here you have to convert these 25 minutes into second. So we know that 1 minute is equals to how many seconds? 60 seconds. Okay, in 1 minute we are having 60 seconds. So therefore, this is the symbol of therefore. Therefore, 25 minutes is equals to 25 into 60 seconds. Clear? Now when you multiply these two, what you are getting? 1500 seconds. It means in 1 minute you are having 60 seconds and in 25 minutes you are having 1500 seconds. So when you have to convert the given number of minutes into seconds, what you have to do? You have to multiply the given number in minutes with 60. When you multiply the given number of minutes with 60, you are getting your answers in seconds. Okay, so this is the way of converting one unit of time to another unit. Next topic is antimeridian and postmeridian. Now, antimeridian we usually write as AM. You're familiar with this one? And postmeridian as PM. Okay, now where you have seen it? Usually we write the sun rises at 6 a.m. Okay, not 6 p.m. Now, why we are writing a.m. and p.m.? This only we are going to understand. Okay, then when we have to write a.m. and when we have to write the p.m. Okay, so the concept of a.m. and p.m. we are going to understand here. Now, we know that in one day we are having 24 hours. Okay, so for separating this a.m. and p.m., what we have done, we have divided this 24 hours into two equal periods. That is one period of 12 hours and another period of 12 hours. Okay. So what we have done, we have divided the 12 hours into two equal periods. Now first is your AM, which is your antimeridian. AM is before midday. So before your midday, we always use AM. It is the time from 12 o'clock at midnight to 12 o'clock at noon. So from 12 o'clock at midnight to 12 o'clock at noon, what we use? We use AM. Okay? Next is your PM. PM means post meridian. Now PM is after midday. After midday, what we use? We use PM. It is the time from 12 o'clock at noon to 12 o'clock at midnight. So from 12 o'clock at noon till 12 o'clock at midnight, what we use? We use PM. Therefore, we say in morning at 7 a.m. Okay, and in evening, what we say? 7 p.m. Clear? Now, next topic is calendar. We all know that what is a calendar. Okay, we have seen these calendars in our home, school, offices, everywhere we use calendar. So, what is a calendar? A calendar is a record of all dates, days, weeks, and months in a year. So, what does a calendar consist? A calendar consists of all the dates, days, weeks, and months in a year. Okay, it keeps the record. Now, we know that in 1 week, how many days we are having? In 1 week, we are having 7 days. Okay, then there's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So, in 1 week, we are having 7 days. In 1 year, how many months? 12 months. Okay, in 1 year, how many months we are having? 12 months, that is your January, February, and goes to your November and December. Okay, now in 1 month, how many days? How many days we are having in 1 month? So, in 4 months, named as your April, June, September and November. In all 4 months, we are having 30 days. Okay. So, these 4 months consist 30 days and the rest 7 months consist 31 days. Okay. For example, your January, then March, then May, they all contain 31 days. Now we are having 1 month whose name is February. So in the month of February, we are having either 28 or 29 days. Okay, in April, June, September and November, we are having 30 days. In rest of the months, we are having 31 days except February. In February, we are having 28 or 29 days. Clear? Next, we are having leap year. Now, what is a leap year? I told you that in the month of February, we either have 28 days or 29 days. Okay? So, the year in which February has 29 days, that year becomes your leap year. Okay? So, in total, in 1 year, we are having 365 days. Okay, this is your ordinary year. But in one leap year, as in leap year, February is having 29 days, the total number of days becomes 366 days. Okay, now how we will find that which year is leap year? A year is leap year if it is completely divisible by 4. For example, if I take 2016, okay, and I divide this year by 4. So, let's do the division over here and I'm dividing it by 4. 4 5s are 20, okay, this crosses, you will copy 1 downward. Now, you are copying 2 digits, so you will put 1 0, this you will write 6 and 4 4s are 16. Now, you can see you are getting 0 in your remainder. It means 2016 is completely divisible by 4. Therefore, your 2016 is a leap year. Clear? So, for finding that whether the given year is leap year or not, you have to divide that number of that year by with 4. And if you are getting 0 in your remainder, then it is your leap year. Otherwise, it's your not leap year. It's your ordinary year in which you are having 365 days. Now, our next topic is how do we write the dates? We all know how to write it. First, we will write the day. Then, we will write the month. And then, we will write the year. So, for example, if you have to write March 18, 2015 in date, so how you will write? First, you have to write the day. So, it is 18. Then the name of the month, that is your March. Or March is your third month. So I have written 3 and year is your 2015. So this is the way of writing the date. Now it's your choice. You can separate the day, month and year by putting a hyphen. Or you can write it by putting a dot like this. Or by putting a slash. All are correct. Okay, it's your choice that which one you wants to use. You wants to use the hyphen, dot or the slash. Okay, so student, this is all for today. Here's the end of your chapter number 9, and from your next video we will be starting your revision.